Everyone, I'm going to show you today how to make some vegan peppermints, is what I call them. They're just breath freshening dog treats, and I'm going to show you what you need to make them and how you make them. So check it out. You're going to need milk. I'm using coconut milk. Butter kind of milk of your choice. For vegan, you can use almond, soy, hemp, cashew, coconut, any oat milk, any kind you want. You're also going to need some peanut butter. Just picked up some peanut butter from Aldi's and just quick and easy. You're also going to need oat flour. So if you don't have a place that sells oat flour, or you just don't want to go out and buy oat flour, that's fine. No problem. You can just take some quick oats, very cheap to get, and grind it up in a blender or food processor and make your own oat flour. So I have to do that with mine, but I do have a little bit already done from the last time I made these, and I put it in the freezer, so you can blend up enough and stick it in the freezer for next time. Oat flour. Now, this recipe called for an egg. A couple eggs. Two eggs. But I'm going to be using a flaxseed, which again, I've already ground up into a meal, flaxseed meal, and I'm going to add this to water and make, it's I think a 3-to-1 ratio, and make a flax egg. And that will be used to bind the ingredients together. And you'll need baking soda. Give it a little lift to the dough treats, dough cookies. You will need fresh basil. You could use parsley, you could use mint. This particular recipe that I was using used basil. And last time I made this, I got a fresh basil plant and took that and chopped up. This time, the store I went to did not have fresh basil, neither a plant. It wasn't enough anyway. The plants were so, instead of like a head of basil, something that you would find, I did what I could and I got this basil stir and taste. So it's already kind of chopped up and in a paste. Not the best, but it will do in a pinch. You can also use dried if you wanted to. Fresh is probably better. So you add this to it. And because this is a paste, we're going to use a little less liquid so that we can get the desired consistency. And lastly, what makes these really great for breath freshening for dogs is the peppermint essential oil. So this is awesome for yourself refreshing your breath. doTERRA, the brand I use, which makes awesome quality essential oils. So you make a little beadlet that you can just pop in your mouth and freshen your breath. You can just take a drop and drink some water. And you can just add it to your water for a great refreshing. You can add it to your dog's water dish. Our dogs love it. I love it. See the dish back there? Yeah. We put a drop in their dish and they love it. So this is great. We're going to add this for that great peppermint punch to this for the peppermint peppermint bites is what I'm calling it. So let's get started. Start off, like I said, we're gonna have to take our oats, which are just quick oats, and put them in this in the high speed blender. Probably any blender will do this, but I do have a high speed blender, so I will be using that. But you can definitely use a food processor too. I'm gonna pour it all in because I put leftover in this baggie. I put it back in the freezer. So I will probably mute this part so you can't hear the high blender, high pitch blender sound, but I will get back to you as soon as it's done. Okay, it's nice and blended to a flour consistency now. There you go. And I'll be back with you when I get my bowls and everything ready to go.
Okay, to get started, we're going to put our maker flax egg. We're going to put 2 tablespoons of the flaxseed meal in this bowl, and then we'll put in 6 tablespoons of water. Okay, there we go. Good. We're gonna let this sit a little bit, just so it can gel up in a way. That will be our egg. Next, we need 3/4 cup of milk. Again, I'm using coconut milk, because that's what I have. And this is a cup measure, so we're gonna just estimate. Actually, probably gonna do a half because we have the basil paste that add a little extra liquid, so we'll go with a half of a cup and put it in this bowl. Okay, and we're gonna still let this sit a little bit more and gel up. We're gonna get our peanut butter in here. So we need 1 cup of peanut butter. I'm probably going to use a little peanut butter left in the jar. But you know who gets that. And she just heard me. She just heard the word peanut butter. And she heard me. Hi. Did you want this? Is this what you wanted? Is that what you wanted? Yeah? Yeah, wait a minute. It's about 1 cup exactly. Empty hamburger jar and a corgi. That's waiting for it. Yeah. Go ahead, enjoy. Where are you taking it? Okay, back to the cookies. Alright, we're gonna put this in the bowl here. Okay, next step is our flax eggs. Looks like it's gelling up nicely. Oh yeah, there you go. See? Nice and kind of gel-like. Just like an egg. Oh, yeah. But no cruelty. No animal cruelty. No chickens were harmed. No baby male chickens were harmed in this. Because, yes, in the egg industry, baby male chicks, they can't be used. They can't make other eggs. They just get ground up alive. So yeah, no cruelty. No cruelty and way, way healthier. What? If you've never heard about how good it is, look it up. Look it up, flax seeds. Yeah, so there you go. Nice and gooey. Perfect for binding our cookies together. And dogs will appreciate this too, but they're not getting any cruelty. Love brings a love. Okay, now we're just going to whisk this all, stir this all together. The energy you save from, you know, the energy you get from saving a life, like, that goes back to you and back to your pets. I mean, dogs can live off a vegan diet. And these dog treats, they don't need to be made with cow's milk full of nasty stuff and cruelty and eggs, chicken periods. Yeah, no, these can be made with flax eggs and coconut milk. Yummy peanut butter. That's how they taste. Okay, looking good. So, next step is the dry ingredients. So, I'm gonna get this cleaned up and I'll be back. We are ready for our dry ingredients. That is 2.5 cups of the oat flour. Two and a half cups. And we'll go with 1 tablespoon of baking soda. Teaspoon, not tablespoon. Shh. Next, we're going to stir this up. And actually, since this is kind of considered a liquid, I'm going to add this. This on in. I'm gonna do all of it because you need like half to three quarter cup fresh parsley or basil, sorry. So gonna use all of it. Excuse my one-handed vlogging and cooking, but gotta get done. There we go. We're gonna see if this works because hopefully it does. Okay. And the camera's still lit. Let's see. Anyway, I'm gonna mix this up. Add a little bit more coconut milk because you can add up to like 3/4 cup. Because I didn't add as much before. Kind of go, and you know, you just want a good like dough consistency going on here. It's too dry yet. And then if it gets too wet, all you have to do is like add a little bit more oat flour. You're not dealing with gluten in this. There's no white or even wheat flour in here. It's just all oat flour. So you can stir it as much as you want. And you're not going to do anything bad to it. But yeah, if you add too much liquid, then you can always add a little bit more flour. But I think we're pretty good. So you can't see this much. Thank you.
This is the point that you're gonna add your peppermint oil in. I'm doing 10 drops because you definitely want it mini, you know. Cooking sometimes tempers that strength in the potency, sorry, of the oil. So 10 drops is pretty good. And then you just want to stir that in again. She's enjoying that peeler jar for sure. Okay. Show you the consistency. There you go. Nice. Like, you can make a ball shape of it. Pretty good. Might actually add a little bit more flour just so like it's not so sticky. We'll see. You're not actually going to be doing anything with your too much with your hands with it, but if you wanted to roll these out and cut them into shapes, you could definitely could. They might require a little bit different baking time, but you probably want them to be a little bit drier. But no, I think that's good. Alright, I'm gonna clean up a little bit here and get things ready for baking, and I'll get back to you. Okay, now you want to preheat your oven to 325 and get yourself some nice air bait type like insulated air type cookie sheets, like really nice, and a cookie scoop that'll be a nice size for a cookie. So all you have to do, start scooping. And there you go. And once you get them all done, but you can flatten them. Flatten them down a little bit. They don't have to be perfect. But if you want to tuck in any pieces of basil and pull around there, you can. And that's all you have to do. And then you'll bake them for 15 minutes, flip them, and bake them for 10 more. So I'll be back with you when I finished my trays.
Okay.
I got the cookies all scooped out, flattened. I ended up doing like
swirling up my hand and ball for these ones. And I like the way they look better than this, but these are good too. Just to smooth the edge, less cracks there are, it just makes for like, it doesn't come apart as easy, if you know what I mean, like when you flip it. So, take my extra time to smooth it a bit and roll in your hand. It does help. But I'm going to get these in the oven. Bake for, like I said, 15 minutes. There you go. Flip them over. That's all you have to do, and just come back where they're not touching each other, basically. There you go. Alright. Back in the oven for another 10 minutes. To get the cookies out. Lacey knows. And then the dog treats out. Yeah. Yummy peppermints. My dogs love, and they help freshen my breath. Who doesn't love that, right? There you go.